Praise Jesus. I hope you're all well. And I want to thank you for joining into our week's devotion. My name is Linda Odhiambo, and I'm privileged to be the one bringing devotion to you today. I thank you for joining in and for taking time to listen to this devotion. I pray that this devotion will strengthen you, encourage you, and will help you the way the Lord wanted. So today's devotion, I'll briefly speak about prayer. I'll speak about prayer, and we will have part one and part two. So today I'll speak about seeking God Himself. Yeah. So to the part one of today, it's about seeking the giver and not the gifts. We'll talk about seeking the giver of gifts and not the gifts. So many a times, our needs and the miracles that we want in life, because we have goals and all that, are the motivations, are what motivates us in prayer, which should not be the case. And so we go in prayer for gifts. We go in prayer for miracles and not to seek God Himself. So today I want us to talk about the giver of gifts. Many a times we get these gifts, we get these miracles, God answer our prayers, but then we forget the giver of these gifts. So when we get the gifts, it overwhelms us and we celebrate the gifts and even sway away from God, not remembering that He is the one who gave us this gift. So today I want us to also go to the Bible, and before that, let us have a word of prayer. Father, we thank you, we bless you, we honor you, we adore you, O God. We want to acknowledge you, Jehovah, that you are our source, O God. And without you, we are nothing, O God. Without you, we cannot achieve anything, Lord. And even in this time, Lord, we invite you that you be with us, O God. Give us spirit of understanding, Lord, that we will understand the word that you've prepared for us, O King of all the glory, that even after this word, Jehovah, we'll be different people and our mind, O God, will be renewed. We thank you and we bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. So we'll go straight to the word. I hope you have your Bibles and your notebooks. And I pray that this word will change your life. And from this day forward, you will seek the giver himself and not the gift. These gifts are supposed to follow us according to the word of God. 1 Samuel chapter 1, 10 to 11, then 28. And Hannah was in distress of soul, praying to the Lord and weeping. She vowed, saying, O Lord of hosts, if you will indeed look on the affliction of your handmaid and honestly remember and not forget your handmaid, but will give me a son, I will give him to the Lord all his life. No razor shall touch his head. We'll go to verse 28. Therefore, I have given him to the Lord. As long as he lives, he is given to the Lord, and they worshipped the Lord there. This is the story of Anna. And if you remember, Anna really prayed for the child, for her child, for her son, Samuel. And it reached a point where God answered Anna and gave her a son. And there was a time now, when Anna was praying, he promised God that if God, you give me this child, then I will give this child back to you. Yeah? So the child came and it reached where now Anna had to give the child back to God as she promised. You see, there are many prayers. When we make our prayers, we even make promises to God, thinking that we will fulfill these promises after the gifts come. But Anna fulfilled his promise to God. And remember that Samuel grew in the temple. In the temple, and he was brought in the ways of the Lord. And that was the promise that God, I mean, Anna made to God. How many promises do we make to God when we really need this gift? Do we fulfill this gift? Or do this gift overwhelm us and take us even further from God? So today I just want us to take time, even before we go into prayer for this gift. Let us first seek the giver and ask him to teach us through the Holy Spirit how to ask for this gift. Because at times we even ask and we ask amiss, according to James 4:3. We ask amiss and we do not get because we do not ask. And if we ask, then we do not ask according to the will of God. So we need to know the will of God first, even as we ask. Let us not let the gift not motivate us to go in prayer, but let us seek the giver himself. Because if we seek him with our heart and honestly, then this gift will overflow us. These gifts will actually pursue us and overtake us. So today, be encouraged, and I want you to just focus on God. Let him be your focus. Let the gifts not motivate you. The gifts will catch up with you. The gifts will come. So let us seek God and seek him in truth, in spirit and in truth. And definitely, these gifts, they will pursue you and they will overtake you. So be encouraged, and remember also the story of Abraham. Abraham waited for years for the gift of a son together with his wife Sarah. And even when Isaac came, Abraham did not forget the giver. Even when God asked for the son, he was so faithful and even was ready to sacrifice this gift. How many times are we even ready to give back our gifts, the gift that we've prayed and fasted for years, back to God when he needs this same gift? Are we ready to do that? So it is, I'll pose it as a challenge to us and even to me myself, that even when we seek the giver, yes, he will give us the gift, but let us remember to give back this gift. Giving is an attitude. So let us have this attitude of giving the best. Because remember Abraham and even Hannah, they gave the best. Whatever God gave them is what they gave back to God. Are we ready to do that? Are we willing to do that? Do we have that attitude to give back to our God the same way he has been faithful to give to us? Are we ready to give back our gifts to him, knowing that we've given him the best, the way he's giving us the best? He's given us Christ Jesus, our Savior. He gave us the best. So are we ready to also pick the best of the gifts that he's given us back to him? So let us seek this giver. Because when we seek him and we seek his will, then these gifts will follow us. These gifts will not sway us away from God, will not push us away from God, but will align us. We will trust more in God and trust for bigger and greater things. Hallelujah. I hope you're blessed, and may this be a challenge for you this week, that you will seek the giver of gifts and not the gifts. Hallelujah. God bless you. Amen.